In this slide, we'll talk about why do we need VLAN. So here, there are two examples. One is with VLAN and second is without VLAN. So with VLAN, where you have three switches, one is for engineering department, second is for marketing, third is for sales department. And we can see there are three broadcast domains separated by router here. And you need three switches, separate switches. And you need router to make them secure. But here is the example with VLAN. You can have only one switch acting as three switches, and you can have your network secure using this method. So VLAN will divide this switch into three switches, and each virtual switch, means virtual VLAN we call it, or broadcast domain we call it, that traffic will never go to another VLAN until we use any kind of mechanism to make communication between these. So that is the beauty. It can reduce the cost which we use. That's the advantage of using VLAN. So first benefit is cost reduction, because we don't need the number of devices and we can save the cost. Second is the security. Security is more concerned when we send data from one network to another, or in the layer 3 network. So if we have two, three layer 3 networks and we want to send data through one switch, that means your data is still not secure. So in this case, one device, means the sales department, will not communicate with marketing department because they are not member of the same broadcast domain. Then next benefit is reduce flooding attack. Flooding attack can occur in your network if somebody is going to send data, unnecessary data, or going to spoof your network. It generates a lot of broadcasts. So one person who is sitting here, who is sending a lot of data in your network or generating like MAC attack, MAC address table, MAC flooding attack. In this case, this attack belongs to only this sales department, does not belong to any other, because the flooding will not occur in another VLAN from coming from different VLAN. So that's the beauty. It can reduce the flooding attack. Or if any broadcast is generated from this LAN, it will never pass it to another VLAN. Next is ads in easy management. The management is the concern when we have a big network. So you can divide your this entire network into a smaller subnetwork, and you can give them a name, or you can give them an ID to identify which department or which device belongs to which department. So you can say like there is another department like management, MGMT, and you can create separate VLAN for that department. So it's very easy now to create a separate network for every department. Now performance improvement. The performance improvement occurs when we have VLAN network. As I told here, if somebody is sending broadcast data from this LAN, it will pass here, it will come here. So it means it will never go to another VLAN. So now the data is going separately from each VLAN. So we have security, and data is not passing into another VLAN. So that means if anything is happening in this VLAN, it will never impact other VLAN. That's the performance improvement. Now, VLAN operations. How do we identify the VLAN and how it works? So you can have number of VLANs in different switches. So you can have, for example, one switch. I have a sales VLAN here, and each VLAN has an ID. So I'll give an ID here, VLAN 10. The same VLAN I can have here as well. So it's not only you can have VLAN ID 10 here and you will not have VLAN ID 10 in another switch. You can span in multiple switches. So only you need to identify is what is the VLAN ID here. So switches, they understand the ID and we can understand the name. So you can assign ID and name in this case. Here the ID is made up of 12 bits. So VLAN ID is a 12 bit number comes between the frame and 2 to the power 16. So it gives totally 4096 VLANs. So you can create totally total 4096 number of VLANs. So here I have given this line, VLAN ID is 12 bit number which can provide total 4096 VLANs. And here some of the VLANs are reserved, you can't see them and you can't use them. So VLAN 0, you can't see it and you cannot use it. 4095, you can't use it and you can't delete also. So these are two VLANs, you can't use them and you cannot delete them, you can't see in your switches. So they are made for a special purpose. 0 is made for strict priority, when we have a kind of priority method in your voice network, then this VLAN 0 is used. 4095 is used for dropping the traffic, that I'm not going to explain all these. So we can use 1 to 4094 VLANs in our switches. So these are the benefits of VLANs and VLAN operations. Every VLAN has an ID and switches, they identify VLAN based on this number. So number is associated with every VLAN.